Welcome to our channel. For those of you who are new around here, we're Pal Tiya International and we created a sculpting medium called Pal Tiya Premium that looks and feels just like clay but cures stone hard. Check out our other videos to see for yourself what's possible. If you haven't seen part one of this video where we showed you how to make the roof and the core of your birdhouse, then go check it out. It's been curing for 5 days now, so it's time to clean it up. Using a fork and a rasp and some pliers, just remove everything that isn't Pal Tiya Premium from your sculpture. This can get really messy, so make sure you have cleaning supplies handy. File the edge to knock off any roughness. And you can use sandpaper to smooth and neaten your sculpture. In a well-ventilated area, you can burn off any final fibers with a chef's torch or a lighter, just to get a nice, smooth finish. To strengthen where the wires will support the house, lightly spray with water, both the core and the roof. Mix up a little bit of your Pal Tiya Premium and apply a plug of it to the inside of the roof. This will thicken the tip of the roof if it became too thin. Time to push an 8-gauge wire through to make the hole. And now we do the same for the core. Again, push through an 8-gauge wire. It is important to cure this extra Pal Tiya for another 3 days, remembering on the second day to add those wet towels. Bend a U-shape wire for the house and fit the U-wire into those support holes that you made 3 days ago. On either ends of the wire through the roof, bend an S onto the end of the 8-gauge stainless steel wire. And now you have your completed decorative birdhouse. Water-soluble colour pencils are wonderful for establishing your colour patterns. Then, using exterior-grade acrylic paints, paint the big areas of colour. You can draw further designs with a colour pencil and then paint in permanently with the acrylic. A delight to the garden, the fully finished leaf acorn. Acorns can be made quite unique, like this shimmer acorn, where we made the roof slightly smaller, with no window lintels, a different leaf detail, and different paint job. Or the blue acorn, where we made a longer roof, kept the bottom flat, and added no details to the house core. We managed to capture some of the making of the summertime lace acorn. So you start off the same way, and this time we covered a funnel with foil for the roof. Mix a small batch of Pal Tiya Premium and mark on your house core where you'd like the lace to go. Then take it off and apply a scratch coat to the surface. Pre-mist your lace, and then using a very small amount of product, place it on the back of the lace to pick up the detail and give it a scratch coat. Lightly mist your house core scratch coat, and then with your tools and hands, firmly press on the lace. Finish your details on your house, and you're going to cure as normal. Curing instructions are below. On day two, when you go to wrap it in wet towels, that's when you'll remove the lace. And then the roof we did very similarly to the leaf acorn. After curing and removing that lace, the detail that's left is beautiful when painted. And then hung it in the garden. And there you have it, acorn four ways. We'd love to see you try it. Next in our birdhouse series, floating palace. So if you want to see how we made this and get more behind the scenes, become a Pal Tiya insider at paltiya.com. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.